a los dos traviesos, ¿verdad? También nos dicen la traviesa y usted travieso. Estamos en Art Alley. Estamos transmitiendo en vivo. Vamos a estar de 1 a 5. Y como pueden ver, along el alley hay varios artistas. Los niños están haciendo rock painting. También hay dance folclórico. Dicen que hay comida, no hemos visto un poquito más para allá, pero al ratito nos vamos a aventurar un poco hacia el fondo. Estamos aquí con Elvia, que ya se está echando una bailadita aquí, una rola de rap. Y hay tamales.
Ay, ¿dónde está? ¿Dónde había tamales? ¿What? Sí.
Ahí están la comida. Y
como fui por los tamales.
Hay niños, adultos, ancianitos, de todo hay aquí disfrutando. No me van a negar que para ser octubre la temperatura está bastante bonita. No creo que el año pasado estábamos así de caluroso, así que vénganse, dense una vuelta. Aún no es tarde, vamos a estar hasta las 5, ¿verdad, Don Mami? Radio Horizonte, estamos como les digo en vivo en el 96.5.
Sí, como ya lo digo, Taide, estamos en vivo aquí en el Downtown de Goshen, Indiana. Estamos en un día muy especial, ya que este día lo han designado para las artes latinoamericanas. Y hay muchos artistas aquí al lado de nosotros. Si puede traer la cámara hacia este lado, María. Estamos en la calle Main, en la calle Washington. En este lugar es donde se está llevando esta exposición de arte de lo que es la cultura mexicana y latinoamericana. También se dice que tenemos artistas peruanos el día de hoy. Así que si usted todavía tiene tiempo, se puede venir aquí al Downtown de Goshen. Estamos en lo que es la Main Street y la Washington. Está de alley a alley. Si usted llega por el estacionamiento público de la ciudad, usted también va a ver el otro lugar donde va a haber música en vivo. Así es que la invitación para que se venga, María. ¿Quiere que caminemos todo el equipo o vamos de regreso para explicar más o menos acá? Bueno. Así que la invitación para todos, todavía hay tiempo, va a estar el evento hasta las 5 de la tarde. Y esto es lo que se está haciendo, ¿no? Artistas que les encanta la pintura, lo han venido a hacer en exposición. Además han traído como calaveras. Y aquí podemos ver, esta es una, dice Rosa Aguilar, encuentro en el alley. Esta es una máscara es tradicional en México para el Día de los Muertos, y hay de diferentes también. Estas son pues obras que se fueron seleccionadas para traer al día del evento el día de hoy. Así es que esto está buenísimo aquí en el alley. Radio Horizonte 96.5 FM, pues ha sido invitado a venir acá. Ya lo sabe, todavía hay tiempo, María. Cuente.
Claro que sí. Aquí tenemos ahorita a las 3:45 va a ser Nayo y los amigos, 4:30 Día de Muertos y 4:45 y a cerrar. Aquí está el sketch para los que quieren ver lo que está pasando en el día de hoy. Muchachas, ¿qué?
Hay que preguntarle a ella qué fue lo que encontró al otro lado de en la otra parte donde se está llevando la exposición.
Sí, lo que encontré es artistas que son de aquí del área y otras personas que trajeron venden arte, todo, que me estaba comentando una persona en especial que trae bolsas, calaveritas, aretes, todo. Dice que ella se encarga de ir a México y contactar a los diferentes gente que tiene arte. Entonces, artesanías mexicanos, y va a diferentes estados de México y ellos se encargan de mandarle lo que ella vende aquí, entonces lo mandan directamente de allá a aquí. Entonces, eso pude platicar con
what we can say in English because we have people that...
Hi, hey. So we're here at the Art Alley and we're going to be here 1 to 5. Very interesting. It's my first time. I am seeing various artists and for some of the artwork is for sale. Down the alley you're going to find folkloric dancers, and also we were saying that some of this art actually comes from Mexico. So you're going to be purchasing something that is actually made big little sticker that says, oh, I bought it at the art gallery, and then it has that little made in China sticker. No, this one is actually made in Mexico, so you're buying authentic art.
What do you think if we can ask them what they
do? Definitely!
Yes! You guys just got here. Here's a little map of every little station, so you guys can go walking around, and then we'll see you on the way back and let us know what you guys think about. Okay. Look who's here.
96.5 FM live here at the Art Alley. Yeah, Encuentro in Alley. I just arrived too, so I might need one of those pamphlets so I can go see stuff. Because I don't know what to say.
We have them right there. What do we have? We have them right there.
We had an interview with some of the organizers yesterday, right?
We got to move with Idris, and Idris can walk through the
Okay.
And to ask what's going on. Yes, you take the camera.
Okay.
Why don't we
and you be the reporter.
All you guys, right. You guys want to go and talk, and I'll go. I'll walk with you guys.
These are actually from high school kids. These are high school kids.
I actually know one of them. She's standing right there, Yadira. Yes? Yes. Yes. Looking nice.
Oh, wow.
These are high school kids. How's that?
Oh, that's good.
How's that?
That's good.
How are you? Ready for today?
Are you going tonight?
Yes. Yes.
Are you a pit parent?
Yeah. No. But I'm the uniform mom, you know that. I make sure they all look good and sharp. Oh, yeah.
Stinky.
Yeah.
Yes, yes.
Look at this.
And that is by...
This is by Jennifer Escobedo, Untitled. Wow. I am just saying it's just...
Jennifer Escobedo is actually a high school student.
These are all mostly high school students.
And you see the U.S. flag and the Mexico flag. And what do you think, what do you think about that image?
I just think it's a mixture of culture sometimes, especially us, that we... were brought as children, or we grew up here in the United States. Sometimes we feel like we're kind of in the mix, halfway American, halfway Mexican. At least that's how I feel. A clash of cultures.
You did really good.
But you
really
take good. The good from both of them.
Yeah. Let's see.
I think I got to speak with Geraldo.
Gerardo?
Uh-huh.
Oh, really?
About the youth movement in Mexico. I guess he's part of it.
What I'm also going to do. And your picture, I'm
going to
put this in front of you.
Nice. It's
really nice. How are you doing today? I'm doing good. We are with Horizon Radio 96.5 FM. And congratulations. I saw that on a Facebook page. You guys little big idea. And how has that been going so far?
As you can see, we're staying busy.
Yes, yes. What do you think about this event, Encuentro in Alley, though?
It's a good turnout. I didn't think it was going to be as big as this.
Alright, and the night is still young.
It is.
Alright, thank you for talking to us.
Young and caring
artist. Mm-hmm. I like that. Ninja Turtle. He's amazing.
So let's see. What are you guys inspiring? What are you guys doing?
They're better.
I see Pikachu right there. But what are you guys doing?
I'm inspired by my mom, so I'm making some chocolate.
Some chanclas?
Yes.
Nice.
Awesome. I need to make one. We all need to make a chancla.
Look. But look, you can tell they know how to draw, because look at the flowers. I like that. Now, is that one of your masks that is over there? Is that one? No, that's not yours. I'm confusing it with Jadira. One of the masks that was made by one of the high school students. Yeah? Okay, okay.
So they're like, okay, don't make me get the chakra out.
What are you making?
I'm trying to make like the galaxy or something.
The galaxy? Which one? Which one's the blue one? Just random one? Let's see your Pikachu. Everybody wants to see your Pikachu. Right? Because that is Pikachu, right?
Yeah, poor Pikachu.
Turn it around? Yeah.
Had a terrible
okay.
Accident.
I guess. One he lightning.
There you go. Yeah.
What did she make?
This is the stars. And Jen, you explain it. It's yours.
It's a little house.
I'm going to do a video of
it. But I think
like a bonfire?
Yeah. And then we didn't see, there were supposed to be shooting stars yesterday, but we didn't see any. So
really?
We stayed up for no reason.
Oh, did you guys stay up late for him?
2 a.m.
Yeah.
Wow. 2 a.m.?
I think she's going to make a great profit here because who does not need every Hispanic home needs a chancla, and what better way to make it out of rocks?
Oh wow! I don't know if I want to walk on those.
I'm gonna get the chancla.
Okay, let's go to the other side.
Yes.
Here's another nice painting. The same one again. She's really good. Jennifer Escobedo's really good. We have the, she's in our bed. No, I hope not. This is really nice though. That one. These are really, really nice. Let's go to the other side. So these are like, oh, look at, don't we see these? Señor Jose Ortiz, photo by Jose Ortiz. Look at that, captures the sugar candy. These are the bomb. I haven't had the green one. I've had the blue one and the pink one. Yummy, yummy. Aww. The chiles.
Hey, I'm going Yahoo. I'm going Yahoo.
Who do we have here? Isaías. Ya bailó, ya bailó. ¿Sí? ¿Dónde dejamos a la boricua?
Todavía de luna de miel.
¿Todavía? ¿Y usted que no tiene que andar con ella? Bueno, vamos para el otro lado. So, Ali, you cross the main street and you wait because, you know, there's traffic. But it's between Washington and what is it?
Lincoln.
Between
Lincoln and Washington.
It's between Lincoln and Washington. Head on over. It's going to be here open till 5 p.m. So, para toda la gente que se está sintonizando aquí en el Facebook, estamos ahorita en Main Street de aquí de Downtown Goshen. Y hoy se decidieron juntar la cultura, y hay artesanías, comida, música, un poquito de todo. So, ¿por qué no venir a apoyar aquí a la comunidad? Y pues aprender con los niños un poquito.
Yeah, we're gonna collaborate.
Okay. That's how you do it?
With the dress, you need the dress.
Okay.
What do we have here?
I don't know.
Okay, so what do we have on this side? This is 10,000
musical instruments. I think these are, how do they say, the interactive art pieces.
Oh,
musical
okay
instrument the kids can play with.
Nice.
Y'all are welcome to pick any of them up and try them out.
Okay.
And you are?
I got Colin here. Brad Collins.
Are you with 10,000 Villages?
My wife is. I just happened to be drafted to help today. It's a great day.
Somos opuestos.
This is what we're supposed to do to let people and kids come experiment with instruments from around the world. Kind of neat.
What's the name of
the alley? I like it. Yeah, I like it. I think we need to use the alleys to do more events. So it looked up pretty good. I would imagine this won't be a long time. about yourself?
I just arrived, but I interviewed Mr. Piero yesterday, one of the artists.
So where are you from?
From Nigeria.
Okay.
But I am.
But you didn't come from Nigeria for this.
Yes. Mm-hmm. I thought that was what you meant, like origin wise. I am an origin radio or something. I'm good in the same building. Yeah. Sure. My language is going to be good.
Alright.
Anything special you want to say? Facebook Live?
No? Everybody come out. Well,
yeah.
Great.
All right. Thank you. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Yeah,
these are what?
Los recaudan son para una iglesia en Perú y el libro es escrito por la esposa de él. Es su primer día, él viene de Perú, está visitando
de Perú.
Sí.
¿Cómo le gusta aquí en Goshen, oiga? ¿Cómo le gusta aquí en Goshen?
Muy bonito.
Sí.
Tras
los hijos del bosque. Cuando una joven ciudad decide dejar su tierra para servir a la selva. Wow.
Bueno, pues mucho gusto, ahorita regresamos.
¿Qué es? Vamos a esperar a esta mujer.
¿Nos pueden decir un poquito más de la iglesia?
Bueno, yo soy pastor, misionero, ¿no? Yo predico por los ríos, por las comunidades. Allá no hay carretera, todo es por ríos. 20 horas, 10 horas, 2 días, 3 días de viaje por ríos. Entonces, ahí hay iglesias donde necesitan mucha enseñanza de la palabra de Dios. Los pastores muchas veces no son preparados, no tienen preparación bíblica, teológica, porque no pueden ir a la ciudad porque el asunto del dinero. Trabajamos con niños, trabajamos también con jóvenes, trabajamos con jóvenes, los jóvenes necesitan mucha enseñanza. Muchos problemas tienen los jóvenes, pero también trabajamos con mayores, de familias, con padres de familias. Hacemos campamentos, invitamos. Que siempre estamos haciendo este eventos grandes. Invitamos a varias comunidades vienen de los ríos para escuchar. Sí, ahora voy a buscar el compromiso para ir a predicar en grandes concentraciones. Como hay demasiadas comunidades, uno no puede vestir uno por uno. Necesitaría mucho tiempo para concentrarnos en un sector. En otro sector, en otra zona, sí. Así también podemos aprovechar el tiempo. Yo fui también traductor de la Biblia.
Sí, él estaba traduciendo la Biblia entre español a chipibo.
Mi idioma, ¿no?
Ok.
Ese es un lengua nativa.
Sí.
Muchas gracias.
Sí, de igual manera, ya. Bienvenida. Ok.
Have a good day.
I am a professor at Goshen College. How I met him is because I was with my husband for a year taking SSTS to study as a semester of the study abroad.
Abroad.
So that was a while back, right? Or is that recently?
That's recently. We just came back from Peru in August.
Oh, okay.
They live in poverty, and so we help them a lot. And he just
indigenous.
Not just Quechua.
Yeah, okay.
Many indigenous people in Peru.
Nice, okay.
Cosmovision.
What is that supposed
to be?
Some of us as adults were still saying that, I think we need to be mindful and then not mistake.
Exactly.
But they already became the kids.
Exactly. Like, and that is why we believe he is doing a very good job, because he is the bridge between the Chipibos in the jungle and the Chipibos in Lima.
What a pleasure.
How has his work impacted the people in the jungle and the people in the city? I mean, what has he been able to facilitate?
How impactful, for example, what is the influence he has tenido en ustedes, por ejemplo, viniendo de la comunidad chipiva, en su cultura, con la cultura que tiene el Cantagallo?
Bueno, hay dos tipos de impacto.
There are two kinds of influence.
Negativo y positivo.
Negative and positive.
Los jóvenes, niños que crecen, que vienen de la comunidad mío.
So the children who come from very young age.
Cuando crecen los niños, pierden.
They lost.
Porque hay discotecas.
Because they have, you know, discotecas.
Se ponen a robar.
They steal things because they are poor, so by necessity they have to steal stuff from other people.
Pocos jóvenes se esfuerzan para estudiar.
But there are some of them who really want to study, to be something in life.
Los jóvenes se confunden, se marean.
So they get confused about both worlds.
Porque es otra cultura.
Because it's another culture.
Es difícil vivir en la ciudad.
And it's really difficult to survive.
Vivir en un pequeño espacio.
It is really hard to live in that small space.
Sin servicio de agua.
Without water.
Servicio de luz.
Without electricity. It is difficult because everything is money. But some of them, you know, they go ahead and have a very bright life future. So many of the young people, they go to because necessity.
Otros sí trabajan duro para salir adelante.
So, but many of them struggle a lot, but they go ahead and they become professional.
Ellos tienen mucha oportunidad para estudiar en la ciudad.
Basically, why the GPOs are coming to Lima is because they don't have a lot of school and they don't have a lot of education. The government don't care about them. So they have to move to the city in order for them to get a good education. But that's
around the world.
They do not imagine what kind of world they're going to find. And that's why the result of how some of them impact successful and some of them fail.
Now for an organization or a people who are watching on Facebook right now, if they want to help out
the people, community,
how can they do that?
They have to get in touch with him, and if you want to, you can get in touch with me too. I work at Goshen College. saw my husband, and we can contact them too.
Okay. So there's no contact information or like that?
Oh yeah, they have their web page. Ustedes tienen una página web, ¿verdad?
Sí, sí.
They have a web page.
What is the web address?
They have a business card.
Oh, okay.
He has a business card.
We don't know who was listening and if people are, you know, wanted
interested,
yeah.
Action.
Yeah, the only thing that I want to say that in the year that my husband and I were there taking college
students,
and this year his email too.
Oh, okay, good.
And also the other stuff that I want to say is that people
pero
think that Peru
página web
is just
Quechua
speakers.
Se llama página web.
But this is the web page.
The web page?
Yeah.
What does it say? No,
Sons of the Rainforest? Hijos del Bosque?
Abajo, en inglés.
Yeah, Hijos del Bosque, right there, Sons of the Rainforest.
Oh, Sons of the Rainforest.
Yeah.
That's the translation for
Hijos del Bosque.
Oh, Hijos del Bosque. Ahí puede entrar, ahí puede entrar.
So you can go in there and you will find more information.
Okay. Gracias. Gracias. And right now we have the kids are dancing a folklorico.
Oh, congratulations. Are they sponsors to us?
They are sponsors to us, yes. The question is, what do you think of our community? ¿Qué te parece la comunidad? That's what kids write.
I don't make good hearts.
Love it.
I don't make it look cool.
That's supposed to be a heart?
It's supposed to be a heart. Let's help them out.
All right, thank you.
Face it.
All right.
Let's go get something of the little dancing.
So I can put my kids to dance.
Folklorico.
They don't forget where their heritage comes from.
Rising Radio 96.5 FM, still at Influential in Alex, and we'll be talking to, can you give me your name again?
Yes, I'm Nata.
Nata, and he's with Ryan's Place. Can you tell us what Ryan's Place is about?
Ryan's Place is a center for grieving children and their families. We service all of Elkhart County, also Kosciuszko County, and St. Joe County as well.
Yeah, in those places that you have serviced, I mean, you said it's for children, right?
Children, teenagers, and the whole family can come. Everyone is welcome. And we have different groups, and they are divided by age, or some other categories that we have.
What would you say is the mission?
The mission is to provide a safe environment for people to talk about their feelings, their experiences with grief, just to listen to each other. We don't give a lot of advice. It's more listening and providing the same advice.
Do you have any questions? Sure. All right. Well, if people who want more information, where can they go to find more information about Ryan's Place?
They can go to ryanspace.org or they can reach us. We have our listener card right here. And our phone number is 574 574- 1000.
Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Okay, look at the jewelry. The girl.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Do you want to go up there with them? Oh, they're going to dance behind you.
Horizon Radio 96.5 FM, live at Encuentro in Alley, and we're about to witness an amazing display of culture here at this superb event, sponsored by Goshen Community Mission and Little Big Grant.
Come on.
your best. Where can we find more information about your troop? The name of our group is called Juanes de San Juan Evangelista. So we are sponsoring our title, our name is San Juan Evangelista, San John Evangelist, our church. If you have any information, you can call Ana Salazar. Her number is 574-533-3363. Not yet. No social media yet, but if you do do social media, Virginia, will you send it to the art camp? Make sure you put it on the public post. That would be great. Thank you so much for coming. And one more hand for the dancers. And in about 15 minutes, we have a special treat for you all. The world famous Nayo and Friends are going to be doing their wonderful traditional music. So stick around, check out the, I believe Goshen College still might have some tamales left. And on the other side of our alley, our visual arts display is up. Highlighting Latino and Latin American artists here in Goshen. We have two kiosks with permanent displays, and then we also have original artwork and Day of the Dead masks. Around 4:30, we're going to be doing the history of the Day of the Dead, so stick around that for that, and we'll be back in a few minutes with Nayo and Friends.
En unos 15 minutos vamos a tener los sonidos milenarios de Nayo Ulloa y varios músicos amigos, así que en unos 15 minutos, por favor, no se lo pierdan. También a las 4:30 vamos a tener una exposición educativa muy bonita sobre el Día de los Muertos en inglés y español. Si no han podido ir al otro lado de la calle Main a ver la exposición de arte, no lo quieren perder, por favor. Creo que los muchachos de Goshen College aún están vendiendo tamales, así que si gustan un tamalito. Y tengo entendido que todos los fondos de lo que ellos están vendiendo hoy va a ir para tanto los damnificados de México como de Puerto Rico, de los huracanes. Así que en un ratito más tendremos los sonidos de Nayo Ulloa. Y como digo, a las 4:30 vamos a tener una pequeña presentación sobre el Día de los Muertos. Gracias.
All right. How's everything going? Hello. Hello. One of the vendors here at Encuentro in Ali.
I have a family picture.
Fantastic display of photography.
Maybe I'll show you on my phone.
What is the best
thing? For family pictures?
Photography.
It's kind of wherever you want to be. I mean, I know some places that wouldn't
work out. Horizon Radio 96.5 FM, live, broadcasting live from Encuentro in Ali. Beautiful display of art here at Ryan's place. Oh, Jewel. Hello. Also, Center for Healing and Hope. Ryan's place, we have seen that. And in about a few minutes, or in some few, in a moment, they will be staging an oratory about the history of the Day of the Dead here in Encuentro in Ali. So stick around so you don't miss that. Community Relations Commission of Goshen. Sponsors of Encuentro in Ali. it goes, the recognition of similarities and differences within the community, and the Community Relations Commission declares its commitment to follow principles of respect for each other, respect for each other's rights, open communication and engagement, honesty, safe community, acceptance, the change as positive and negative consequences, tolerance of differences, support for equality and freedom from discrimination. And you can join in embracing the aspiration that we actively pursue here in our positive community of Goshen, Indiana, in which the community relations tries to encourage.
No te pares,
we're heading back to the other side of Encuentro in Ali, where all the art displays are at. Maybe talk to a little artist, talk to some artist who have works on display. And it is, there's still more time. There's still time for you to come around to Encuentro in Ali. And it's on both sides of the alley. The music is on one side and the artists are on the other. I'm crossing over to the artist side. Hey, Alex. This is Encuentro in Ali photographic display. Art with cultural undertone. Hello. Oh, I know that guy. Yes, one of the sponsors of Encuentro in Ali, the Little Big Grant, or Little Big Idea Grant. You can find them online at littlebigideagrant.com. More art in the alley. We are back where we started with Goshen Rock. Hello. We're actively painting and participating. And we are, the master we talked about. Here's the Day of the Dead, I'll just say it that way. Made by students, high school students. In a minute, there's gonna be like an oratory about the history of the Day of the Dead. You don't want to miss it. It's on the other side of the alley. Encuentro in Ali is happening live and direct. It's gonna be going on till 5 p.m. on Horizon Radio. It's gonna be here to cover all the bases. Stay tuned to 96.5 FM Horizon Radio. And stay tuned to our Facebook page so you don't miss any moment of it. Yes, you do not want to miss any moment of it. Hi, Dave. Hi, Dave. How you doing?
Good, how you doing? Congratulations.
Doing good. Hey, thank you. Thank you very much. Yes. Thank you. All right, I'm just going to sit down. I'll give her the phone.
Mi cuñada es de Ecuador.
Pero regaló una amiga.
Ella es de Honduras.
Soy hondureña.
Oh, wow.
De padres estadounidenses.
Pero de siempre que todos luchamos contigo.